Hi, in front of me I have Realme C3 and I'm gonna show you how to go through the first setup on this device. Let's start by selecting the language. To do it, you can swipe up and down on the screen right here to scroll through the list of languages, find the language you like to use and tap on it to select it. I'm gonna select English United Kingdom, for example, like this. Down here you can tap on emergency call to call the emergency numbers if needed, like this. You can also tap on this icon right here, accessibility icon, to access some accessibility settings. Here you can enable them by tapping the switch like that, and you have settings like a font size, a triple tap to zoom in. You can also turn on the select to speak. Let's turn it off. Go back. Once you're done selecting a language, tap on next. Now we need to select the region. You can again swipe up and down to scroll through the list of regions, find the region you like to use and select it by tapping on it. I'm gonna select United Kingdom, then tap next. Here we need to agree to the terms of use. You can check the boxes separately by tapping on them, or you can tap on the box at the bottom right here to check them all and then tap next. Now we can connect to Wi-Fi. You can also skip this step by tapping skip button right here, but I recommend you to connect to one. To do it, select the network from the list right here by tapping on it. And now I need to enter the password, so give me a few seconds. And once you're done entering the password, tap on join right here. And after a few seconds, it should be connected to the network. Then tap next to continue. Now we can enable the Wi-Fi assistant option by tapping the switch right here. Basically what it does is it's gonna try to connect to the best network in the area on your phone, automatically of course, if you enable it. Then tap next. Now we can copy apps and data from a Google account. To do it, tap next and follow the instructions on the screen. But in my case, I want to set up this phone as new, so I'm gonna tap on don't copy. Now we can log in into a Google account. You can also skip this step by tapping skip button, but I recommend you to log into one. So tap right here, enter the account name or email address. Then tap next. Now we need to enter the password, so give me a few seconds. And once you're done entering the password, tap on next to continue. Now, usually you won't see this screen because it's account bound. Basically, it asks me to update my data on the account, so I'm just gonna tap skip right here, but you can also tap yes, I'm in, and set up your account up to your preferences, but I'm just gonna tap on skip right here, then tap on I agree. Right here we can turn on and off some of the Google services by tapping the switch next to them, like this. And once you're done, scroll all the way down and tap on the accept button. Now we can agree to turn on location services if you want to, or disagree. Tap on the option you like. I'm gonna tap on disagree. And here we can finish the setup and continue it later, or continue it now and finish it completely. So basically you can tap on leave and get reminder to finish it now and then set up your phone later completely, or you can tap on continue and finish the setup now. I'm gonna tap on continue. Here, let's tap on next, then tap on more. And now, if you want to set up a voice assistant, tap on I agree, but I'm gonna tap on skip right here because I don't want to do it, to skip this step. Here we can set up a lock screen, basically password, pin or password, or pattern, my bad, on your phone, so it's gonna be protected. To do it, tap on settings and follow the instructions on the screen, but I'm gonna tap on later to skip this step and then tap later again. Here we can enable some options that the phone is recommending, like auto update overnight. You can tap the switch to enable it, or you can also tap on home screen icons and select the type of icons on your phone. You have a few options. Just gonna select default and go back, then tap next. And here we can import data from a different device. To do it, tap on import data from an old phone and follow the instructions on the screen. But in my case, I'm gonna tap on later to skip this step. Then tap on get started. And at this point, the setup is complete. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing to our channel and leaving the like on the video.